Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
In Cut the Clutter today, we talk about an unusual phenomenon in Indian politics, that somebody who's not particularly successful at winning elections, either in his own state or even in his own constituency, becomes India's leading party's star campaigner pan-nationally. Unless you've guessed it already, we are talking about Yogi Adityanath. Look at his track record. He did not win the election in his state for his party. In fact, his party never told anybody he was going to be their candidate for chief minister, because we don't know what the consequences would have been. That election was won for the party by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He was then installed as chief minister. His performance in the state has been quite indifferent, if I may say so. Some time has passed now. But also, he lost a by-election in his own home constituency, the constituency that he represented for a long time in parliament in Lok Sabha, and the constituency where he has his mutt, a large following and a great network of young people, his Hindu Yuva Bahini, etc., etc. In spite of that, he lost. So he lost that by-election. Under his watch, a by-election was lost in his deputy chief minister's constituency also. He did not win his state's election, and yet he is now the third star campaigner in the BJP after Narendra Modi and Amit Shah. In fact, if I may say so, he is more of a star campaigner than Amit Shah in terms of not just his drawing power for crowds, but also in terms of the requests that the party is getting from its candidates. We met a candidate, in fact, in ITRC in Madhya Pradesh, who said to us, BJP candidate, that this evening Yogi Adityanath is coming to speak here. That will determine my future, whether I am winning or not. So he's taken that seriously. So what is this strange phenomenon? This is because BJP is now structuring this campaign not on its performance, either at the center or in the state governments. The chief ministers are talking about their state governments, but basically they want to polarize to a very different degree. To a degree where Prime Minister, being Prime Minister, cannot speak out because it doesn't behove somebody holding the Prime Minister's office. Second, Mr. Amit Shah, even if he did, perhaps will not be so entertaining and will not be taken so, if I may use that expression, seriously by the followers. And third, he really rouses the faithful, because the faithful, the BJP's diehard supporters, they come to listen to basically somebody saying offensive things about either the communities or the leaders or the parties they don't like. So in some ways, Yogi Adityanath has risen as the BJP's Navjot Singh Sidhu, with one difference: Navjot Singh Sidhu is not the chief minister of his state. He's a minister with not such an important portfolio, and that too in a small state. Yogi Adityanath, on the other hand, he is not talking about his performance. In fact, a lot of the times, he's talking really offensive nonsense. For him to go to Hyderabad and say that when BJP wins elections here, first of all, BJP is not going to win elections here. BJP will be, it will be a miracle if BJP gets into double figures there also. But to say that when we elections here, Asaduddin Owaisi, who's been MP there for a long time from the city and is very popular, he's a young leader, he's going to have to leave India, is not just nonsensical, it is offensive. Because you cannot say this to any fellow Indian citizen, least of all to someone from a minority, that if you lose elections, even if Owaisi would lose elections, why does he have to leave India? Why does anybody have to leave India? Everybody in India is not a Malia or Nirav Modi or Lalit Modi who will walk away from India and set up a big household, a big empire in London or someplace. It doesn't work like that. Also, it's below the dignity of somebody holding the office of chief minister in such a big state to talk like this. And this got a very sharp reply from Owaisi himself, who said, "Ye mere papa ka desh hai, ye mere babba ka desh hai." He's not somebody known to talk softly either. But this is something that was completely uncalled for. He's used much other language about Muslims, about changing names, changing the name of Hyderabad. He's been changing names of his cities in UP. It means nothing to the voter if the voter is looking at a party's political proposition. It just means to the voter a great deal in terms of cheap thrills and entertainment, which is what he's providing. Meanwhile, what is happening? His state is in a mess. We carried a story just a couple of weeks back showing how UP, with about as much population, exactly as much population almost as say the state of Pakistan, has about the same social indicators as Pakistan, whereas India overall is way ahead. So UP actually, a state of more than 20 crore people, is pulling down all of India's social and economic indicators. UP's per capita income is less than half of India's national average. UP has severe problems, unemployment, destitution, sickness, and now law and order as well. UP has a very sensitive communal situation, and you have to manage it carefully. You cannot say that my police will manage law and order here, and I will go and then light these little fires all over the country, abusing Muslims or abusing Pakistanis, and sort of not very subtly drawing that that parallel between Indian Muslims and Pakistanis. This go-to Pakistan politics is very dangerous, and to do this while your own state is poorly governed is a very dangerous thing. How dangerous it can be, we saw today. There were riots in the city of Bulandshahr, not far from Delhi in western UP. An animal's carcass appeared, and it was believed it was a cow, and crowds got angry. A police inspector who had gone to quieten things, he was stoned to death. It's a brutal thing to happen. To imagine this happens just across the river from Delhi is quite shocking. These things happen in Kashmir, places like that, stoning, killing of people in uniform. But this has happened right next door to Delhi. So Mr. Yogi Adityanath should ideally be focusing on his state. His state is in a mess. His state can unravel. He's done very little since he took over to consolidate his own hold on the state or to give people an impression that things in Uttar Pradesh are on the mend. On the other hand, he's now just being paraded from place to place, carrying a similar kind of message, which is not political, unfortunately. It is predominantly communal. So it will be a great tragedy if India and the state of UP in particular have to pay for this kind of, to having this kind of an adventurist as their chief minister.